This is Newcap News with Gina Martin.
Good evening and thank you for joining us. A man has been arrested in Cold Lake after police seized marijuana and cannabis resin in his vehicle. The incident happened in October at a vehicle stop in Cold Lake. RCMP seized close to 8 pounds of marijuana and 163 grams of the resin. 56-year-old Ernest Marcellus of Cherry Grove, Alberta, was arrested on scene and has been charged with possession of cannabis marijuana for the purpose of trafficking. He will make an appearance at Cold Lake Provincial Court in December. Customers from Lloydminster and far beyond came out for the city's annual Christmas craft fair. This had business owners thrilled about current and future sales. Josh Ryan has more.
Any apprehension over turnout for the Lloydminster Christmas Craft Fair was erased the moment the doors of the Exhibition Association opened this weekend. Thousands of shoppers walked down the aisles of the show, something that has become a staple of the border city over the past few years.
There's a lot of regulars that do this every year and they aren't stopping.
Some business owners, both local and non-local, have attended the fair for more than 20 years as it's become one of their key events.
It's nice to see people coming and people meet here, and it's a fun gathering place.
It's always busy, and the customers, you know, they're here to buy stuff.
In addition to serving as a starting point to the Christmas season for many shoppers, the interest in buying from home-based businesses has contributed to the show's expansion.
I think that small-town feel and old-fashioned country service, I think that that's something that people really cherish still.
It's manufactured very well because they're doing it on their own at home and they're trying to make it the best that they can.
Merton says food-based businesses have fared better than others in the last 2 years of economic downturn.
Some of the other vendors that have the higher ticketed items, you know, like the paintings and stuff, they're having a little tougher time this year. Our sales are pretty close to what they've always been.
However, with the influx of potential customers attending this weekend, there's a sense of optimism moving forward.
It's a really good day today, and it's jam-packed. And so I think the feel is out there, and I think the economy is starting to turn around, and people want to shop.
Josh Ryan, Newcap News.
A solid win for the Bobcats at home last night as they beat the Canmore Eagles 4-1 at the Centennial Civic Center. The Bobcats dominated the first period with goals by Zach Kaiser, Scott Ivey, and Wilson Northey. The Eagles put up their one and only goal in the second period. And in the third, Nolan Carruthers was able to put up a fourth goal for Lloyd in the third period, making the final 4-1 for the Bobcats. Austin McGrath earning the home star for his work in net. And tonight, the Bobcats are back in action. They'll be taking on the Calgary Canucks. Puck drop is at 7:30.
This is Newcap News